Okay. October 3rd, 2013. Harvest targeted date was 9/29 for this. This is Hope Eye Blue Flower Corn. My F0 Generation 1 Nutrition. It's the first year out with John Kempf and Dan Kittredge and the Nutrient Dense Supply. Been all organic for probably 6 or 8 years now, but John and Dan and those guys really put the rest of those pieces together for me, and how the trace elements and enzymes and trace element cofactors all work in conjunction with the biology. And so on that note, basically, this is the first year I farmed anything on this property. This has been dormant for 20 or more years. It's an old barnyard. You can see there were horses in it up till about 10 years ago. Other than that, it's been basically abandoned. It was not maintained then at all. It was left open, dead pasture. My point ultimately here is that there's a huge difference in the soil in the 4 months that I've been working it already. I'm going to show you, this is native ground. Obviously I haven't worked this section of soil. And you can see it's very hard, and you can see there's a clay. Immediately I'm hitting clay. I have a hard time scratching or digging in that with my finger. It's very hard, and it's very clay-like, and there's no dark humic matter in it at all. Now, so after I learned a little bit about biology from John Kempf, I did a little bit of looking around at some of the different grasses and trees and bushes that were growing here, and I found that around all the rose bushes, there was a whole different soil regime. And just because the rose bushes have been growing here and pumping exudates into the soil and building the soil up, let me show you what I mean. You saw how that other soil was. Let me show you this soil. Look at this. See, it's kind of like organic and like broken up and softer. This isn't the best example here. This is further out from the edge of the rose bushes. But you go back in under here, you can see. Well, you can see that, first of all, everything's darker green here, right in around the bushes. So you can see the biology is active, right? Let me pull some stuff out of the way here so you can see. And like, yeah, look at this. This is an undisturbed spot right here. But look at all that dark matter in there, that humic matter. That's just from the rose bushes growing. Okay, so what I learned was that there's tools in two different toolboxes. One is working with soil and nutrition in soil and biology in soil. And the other is working with foliar feeds, and that plants can build soils even quicker than working with soil directly. And when you work with the two in combination, you can just make leaps and bounds in no time. So let me show you. You saw right here what that soil looked like. And I've been working, like I said, for about 4 months, a little less actually, with this spot, about 3.5 months. I put down some biology. I put down some basalt microfines, some granite microfines, and just some basic trace element support stuff. And I did do foliar feeds at every critical point of influence on the corn. Days 10, 18, and 38, I think, and also every 7 days anyway, to continue building my soil, my biology, and to build up the nutrition of my plants, because I want to build up the genetic capability of the plants, because I'm a breeder. Anyway, so this is how much darker that soil is in only 3 months that I've been working it. This was the same soil. And you can see the top inch and a half of this is already loosened up, breaking up, much moister. You can see the granular type of nature around it. Like, that's a good sign of good moisture soil that's being worked by earthworms and biology. That stuff breaks up nice. You can see how dark it is. And I did put down some leaves as a mulch, just just some oak leaf mulch that I got from a weeding job I did. And let me show you the root system that we've developed on these corn. It's also, you'll notice that it's not just one stalk. This corn is throwing up one stalk, and in most cases, it's throwing out at least one extra stalk afterward. In some cases, it'll throw out two. The popcorn does more than this, but yeah. So, coming out, these are tillers. Supposedly, if you clip the tillers, you'll increase yields. Not true. I would leave your tillers, because look at what the nutrition that those are feeding into your plant. That's not even the main root structure. We're talking about, like, here you go. Now you're down into the main roots down in there. Take you right in there. Yeah. But look at the root structure coming out of this thing. This is one plant. One corn plant. You see now why we have so much ability by working with plants and biology to build soils. Healthy soils and healthy plants really are synonymous with each other. There's no doubt about that in my mind after listening to Mr. Kemp and now having tested all that stuff out. And basically in 4 months I'm able to take soil that wasn't even really growable, put on minimal nutrition and biology and a few foliar feeds, and turn it into high nutrition soil. I cannot wait to see what next year is going to bring in this patch. I think we're going to be putting garlic in here in a couple weeks when this blue flower corn is done. I did another foliar feed on this about 2 days ago. The fruit is actually pretty full. I have pictures which I can share with this. Some of the ones I took down. Here's my cat Dios on the cruise. Anyway. So I'm just going to let it fill out a little more because it's a seed run and we want maximum completed seeds with the highest nutrition possible. And all the trace elements and biology to support that is there. And we want to fill these fruit out completely, thoroughly. So we can increase our genetic potential and hopefully increase our yields year to year. I also made a cross with this stuff to a bloody butcher corn, which I'll show you in the next lot, in the next video. And my goal is to basically make a high-yielding blue flower corn. So we'll talk more about that later. Anyway, so that's a little bit of the taste of soil and how you can work with it, and foliar feeds, and some of the roots that corn produce. So here's a triple, just to show you, the triple stalks. This is from one seed.